Hallelujah, hallelujah, my friend. What a beautiful, beautiful day to give thanksgiving to God. Let's pray. Holy, holy Lord Jesus, we welcome you in our midst today. We welcome you, Holy Spirit, our greatest helper, who never leaves us. Who never betray us. We ask you to come and empower us to live fully for you. I ask you, touch all the viewers, bless them, give them abundance of life, joy. Let your love saturate our hearts and flow through us. It is a week of victory for you to overcome no matter what comes your way. Remember that the scripture says, we are more than a conqueror through Christ. There is for you more than victory in this world today. When the world is seemingly falling apart, the judgment of God coming upon the earth, things being exposed, oh my friend, it's very important to stand tall. Not just be a believer who is weighed down by worries and the things of this world, but being a believer who see what mortal eyes cannot see. Because there is much more than what we see. The things which are not seen, they are more real than what we see. So my friend, as you have seen, God is working the earth today. Hallelujah. You can see his path. You can hear his footsteps. And he is moving all over the nations, exposing. Justice is coming forth. Not only in America, but look what is going on in South Korea, where the two ex-presidents, they were put under house arrest. Look what happened in France with President Nicolas. It's going to happen not only in those nations, but it's going to happen in Rwanda. Justice is going to come in Rwanda. One day, the president also will be arrested. We talk about what we know. It's going to happen. Not only in Rwanda, even in America. Hallelujah. God is playing no jokes. What you sow is what you reap. This is the year of exposure, reaping, and so forth. So my friend, it's very important to focus on God, to examine our lives, to live like him, to become like Jesus. That was my song this morning. My song this morning is that I become like you, Jesus. Is that, my friend, it's very important. More than anything that we can have is that we become more like Jesus, that we have a heart like Jesus, that we overcome. We overcome. In Luke chapter 4, we will look at how Jesus overcame in the wilderness. We saw that according to the book of Matthew, but Luke also talked about Jesus. Chapter 4, verse 1. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, he returned from the Jordan and was led around by the Spirit in the wilderness. that you have done. Stop being a fault finder. Jesus is taken in the wilderness. Yet, the Bible says, he is full of the Holy Spirit. He was coming from the Jordan, leaving Galilee. He is coming into the wilderness, coming from Galilee to the Jordan. He was baptized. The Holy Spirit fills him. And behold, the Spirit of God led him in the wilderness. It's not the devil driving you into testing and trials. God is the one who guides you, lead you, because he is the one who has the last say in whatever is going on in a believer's life. For 40 days, being tempted by the devil. This is the way you should look at the devil. He's just a tool. Even when he attacks you, he will be a tool that will be used by God to bless you, to bring you to the place where you need to be. So the Lord ate nothing during those 40 days and 40 nights. You can do it. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. And when they had ended, he became hungry. Praise God. Your years of wilderness, they are only temporal. In fact, anything that you're going through on this earth, it's only temporal. We love to nest. We love to be very comfortable. And there are times the Lord gives us rest on every side. But my friend, even if you are resting now, remember, it's only temporal. If you are going through testing and trials, do not worry, do not complain, because again, it's only for a moment. The Bible says, when the time of fasting, testing, and trials, they had ended in the life of Jesus, he became hungry. And the devil said to him, if you're the Son of God, tell this stone to become a bread. When they had ended, the devil comes and he speaks. Just because you're fasting, it doesn't mean you're going only to hear God. There are many people I know who went on a fast for 40 days. They hear a voice. And they believe it was God just because they thought when you're fasting, you can only hear God. My friend, it is to test every voice, every sound you hear, everyone who speaks to you. You have to test. Hallelujah. And the devil is testing him to give up on his fast. I just finished a 21-day fast. When I was doing this fast, in the middle, there is a trial that the Lord allowed me to go through. The first thing I heard when this trial came was a voice that says, oh, see, you're fasting, but look what is happening. Oh, just forget. Stop this fast. Everything will be well. I looked, I said, get thee behind me, Satan. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You did not begin this fast. You cannot tell me how to fast. Get behind me. Hallelujah. We must cast out the devil. We must use the power and the authority in the name of Jesus. So he overcome the first test, but the devil doesn't give up. He's not going to give up as long as we are in this body. Do not complain that you're going from a testing to testing, from a trial to trials. That's a normal Christian life. Just remember, as you take the test in school, they test you. What happens after testing? You go to another level. You go to the next grade. Hallelujah. Every time you overcome the enemy, the Lord rewards you in power. The Lord rewards you in authority. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Don't desire a life where you are not being tested, because that means you're going to stay at the same level. But when I am tested and when I overcome, the Lord bring me to another level, from glory to glory. In order to live this glory, to get to this glory, there is going to be a test. So welcome the testing and rejoice in the Lord that He has found you worthy to go to another level. Some people's test lasts only 3 years. But I have gone through testings that have lasted 7 years without a break. The Lord has made it hard for me because I have prayed and I asked Him, use me mightily, hallelujah. He knows, hallelujah, how to test me. And I love my Lord, my rabbi, my teacher, because He will not give you more than you can bear. That's what the scripture says, my friend. So be encouraged today. Did Jesus overcome the next test? The devil comes to Him and He spoke. He said, I will give you all this domain and its glory, for it has been handed over to me, and I give to whomever I wish. Do not go by the prosperity of a nation and say, look, this president has made Rwanda a beautiful place. Do not just go by that. But how did they get there? By shedding blood, by persecuting Christians, by putting people in jail. So there are people who have the power, who have the word, but it was not given to them by God. It was given to them by the devil. In Hollywood, for example, there are many people who are famous. They have money. They go by a mansion, it's 15 million. They do not care. They have that money. They give the money. But who gave them the money? Do not desire the blessing. Do not desire money that is not blessed. Do not desire to have those 30 pieces like Judas. That was the money of blood. Do not desire money that is not blessed. The Lord is able to bless you, to give you money. You should desire that. You should desire the blessings from the Lord. But do not desire the blessing that comes from the devil, from Hollywood, from people selling their bodies. Women showing their bodies on TV and making money. That money is a curse. And it will throw people into hell. So my friend, you need to check the riches you have and make sure it was given to you by God. That it was not obtained by means of deceit. God forbid, hallelujah. So, he is trying to cause Jesus to worship him. But Jesus is not falling for that. He knows the word of God. He knows the scripture. He tells him, it's written, you shall worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Then he moved to the next one. He wants Jesus to jump down for him. He wants Jesus to go against the will of God. He tempts him using scripture. The devil still quotes the Bible, and the devil still quotes scripture, but he's going to twist it. So scripture has to be used properly. The sword of God has to be used properly. It's to cut the devil. It's to cut anything that's not of God. The sword of God has not been given to us to butcher God's people, to beat them with the word of God. This word of God is not given to us for revenge, for us to beat our people, for us to be legalistic and beat people with it. This word was given to us to guide, to teach, to set the captive free, my friend. The enemy wanted Jesus to die the death besides the death on the cross. He wanted to kill him prematurely. We will go when God say go. We will be raptured when God say it's time. But we cannot be raptured before. We cannot move ahead of God. We must be on God's timing. So Jesus overcomes. This is to tell you that God wants you to overcome every trials and every temptation the devil takes you through. Do not be a people who count, oh, I overcame 90 testing. It's okay if I give in to the 10 temptation of the devil. No. You were created to overcome. You were made to overcome. You have been given victory by Jesus Christ. So my friend, go overcome. The Bible says in verse 13 of Luke chapter 4, when the devil had finished every temptation, he left him until an opportune time. Do you see this word finished in verse 13? When the devil has finished, this is what I was telling you. There is an end to your going through poverty. There is an end to that, and it's coming soon. Because the time to bless the righteous has come. The time for the wealth of the wicked to transfer into the hands of the righteous has come. But my friend, you must be found righteous. You must be found working with him. Do not go there and begin to claim the wealth of the wicked while you have not mended your ways. You must mend your ways. You must put your house in order. You must go before God and say, God, I have done everything you wanted me to do. Here I am. Bless me. Hallelujah. Be found worthy. Be found ready. So there is an end to anything that is oppressing you. In the book of Revelation, chapter 2 and 3, the Lord has a message to the seven churches. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Oh, Holy Father. Oh, Holy Father. Speak to your people. Revive them. Bless them. Bless them. Touch them. My friend, do not be weary. I'm talking to you. Do not give up. Do not quit. Do not give in. Hallelujah. In the book of Revelation, chapter 2 and 3, all the message that I've given to the seven churches. The Lord is telling each one of them, he who overcomes, there is a promise for the overcomer. There are consequences for those who do not overcome. Since the Lord made it possible for us, why would you not choose to overcome everything? There was not a single church, the Lord said, I understand your weakness. It's okay if you don't overcome. No. God is not a weak God. He is a strong God. And overcoming, it's a normal Christian life. Yes, this road is narrow. It's not easy. But you are a fighter. You have the spirit within you that doesn't lose if you're willing. So fight. So stand, so overcome the enemy. When the Lord visits those churches with his message, to each one of them he says, he who overcomes. There is not a single church he left without telling them he overcomes, because warfare will come. And he gave a promise to all the seven churches. When I was reading that this morning, the Lord looked to me and he said, tell my people that all the promise for the seven churches are for them. Don't you go there and just choose a promise and say, this is for me, not the rest. No, he wants to give you abundance. He wants to give you the fullness of joy. He wants to give you abundant life. He wants to give you rich blessing. But the condition, you must be found worthy. Hallelujah. Let's pray. I thank you, God. Hallelujah. Touch your people. Revive your people. Encourage them by this word, God. Heal them. Deliver them from whatsoever they are going through. And most of all, I pray that you will overshadow your people with the power of the Most High, with the power of the Holy Spirit. That the Holy Spirit will overcome over them, empower them to overcome. It's not by might, it's not by power, it's not by your flesh, it's not by your own power. That you overcome addiction, that you overcome alcoholism, that you overcome perversion and all addiction. You overcome by the Holy Spirit. So receive him, and my friend, so overcome. I bless you today. Tomorrow again, we'll have another powerful program. Thank you for watching. Thank you for commenting. God bless you. Until I meet you again tomorrow, remember to rejoice, to smile, and to be happy. In Jesus' name, amen.